So let's look at this one. Okay, K is over here, so I'm working from this angle over here, and I have 17 on this side and 23 on this side, okay? So from angle K, which two sides are these? Well, this one is the opposite. This one is the adjacent leg, and this one is the hypotenuse. Okay, we're not using opposite, we're using adjacent hypotenuse. So which one is this one? Again, this is cosine. So we're taking the cosine of angle K, and that is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, so 17 over 23. So we're going to use our inverse button to work to look for the angle measure. So I'm going to take cosine to the negative 1, or the inverse cosine of 17 23rds. And let's crank that out and see what our angle measure is. Grab your handy dandy calculator. Second function, cosine. Cosine to the negative 1, make sure that's in there. Of 17 divided by 23. Close, equal. So my angle measure at K is 42.3, so I'll round it to the closest degree, which is 42 degrees. So angle K is 42. So that's 42 degrees, okay? So let's try problem three. Again, if you didn't catch that, you can always pause and go back and rewatch this, okay? This one we're looking for, let's say we're going to look for angle R. We have 9 here and 25 here. Okay, so here's our right angle. Which two sides do we have? This side and this side. Okay, from angle R, the 25 is our opposite, and the 9 is our adjacent, and we don't have the hypotenuse. So which trig function uses opposite adjacent? That's tangent. So the tangent of R is equal to the opposite, or 25, over the adjacent, which is 9. And now we're going to use our trig, our inverse trig. So grab your calculators and take second tangent. You should get tangent to the negative 1. And this one is 25 divided by 9. And let's see what we get as our angle measure. 70.2. So it's 70 degrees. So angle R is 70 degrees. Okay, so that's how you figure that out. Now, let's take a second, stop, and think. If this angle is 70 and this angle is 90, what does it force angle S over here to be? Well, we know that these two angles are both acute angles, but they also add to 90. They're complementary. So this angle, we can just go ahead and say, well, if this one's 70, that one's 20, because these have a sum of 90. So you can go ahead and figure out those two sides. Okay? So that's how you find the inverse for your trig function.